Yachty. No blood diamonds, I rock gold like a king. Jewelry so cold, made him blow the nose off the Sphinx. You think I'ma be some type of role model? I go full throttle, desperado, that's the motto. Vic in Chicago, it's you have.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. The Ravens continue to move through the season and want to find a way to secure win number 3 on the year. It's the Bengals going up against the Ravens.
Larry, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Inner Harbor and M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore, Maryland. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Baltimore. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. The 30, 10, and all the way in for a Cincinnati score. A great play there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead. And he's got it to make it 7-0 Bengals. So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now a handoff running off tackle right. And he'll wind up with about 6 up past the 30 to the 31.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
So the offense readies for a 2nd and 4. Give to the fullback on the dive. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. A 3-yard pickup on 2nd and 4. Now they'll need to convert here on 3rd and a little more than a yard. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on 2nd down. To throw is Beathard. And this is going to be incomplete.
Now that's a great opening series defensively. You force what should be a three and out on your opening possession.
And great coverage there on third down to force the incompletion to set up fourth. On is the punt team now as this one sent away. Returnable now for Allen. It'll be a 39-yard punt, four on the return. And the Bengals will take over here first and 10. As he's up past the 35-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
On second down, Wilson out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. That'll go as a loss of 5, and that'll bring up a third down.
Well, that wasn't exactly a work of art, was it?
No, that wasn't a thing of beauty. This is why I don't play in points per reception fantasy league.
Is that what they call
PPR? Receiver still gets a point there. Yeah. And you went that far back. No bueno.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. I wish I had their defense on my fantasy game.
A dump off now to Hill. 10 yards there on a Bengal first. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And he is taken down deep in Baltimore territory. A big play there for the Bengals. 41 yards. And now a first down following that long gain. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. They said there was a lot of discussion in their defensive team meeting room after last week's performance. They had 7 sacks. Something in the water. There's one in the first quarter.
A lot of discussion, a lot of excitement, because now everyone wants to get involved with this. Who's going to continue that process? Who's going to get to the quarterback this week? But they have to be careful. When you have that much pressure, they want to use it against you. Draws, screens, those types of plays.
Let's see if they do that. To throw is Wilson. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10 to the 7. A good pickup there of 20 yards. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
Wilson. And he's going to be dropped. Back at the 15-yard line. This is a nice little stretch he's putting together. Remember, 3 sacks last week.
And now he's off to the races in this game because he thinks, okay, that's the start of something big because he's in a zone. He's locked in. So offensively, you've got to occupy him. Maybe even run the ball at him as opposed to passing it so he can't just pin his ears back and rush the quarterback.
They'll try to run it. It's Hill. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. It's a decent gain on the ground. Call it 6, but it still leaves him with a ways to go on 4th and goal. And his kick here is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. So the drive takes him inside the 10, but it ends with just 3.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Ravens offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And on the first drive, three and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Over the middle, it's complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. So this brings up a second and two. Second quarter now. Brandon Gaughton, Charles Davis with you. And some options here for the offense on second and two.
Here we go now.
To throw is Beathard. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
To throw. That is caught. It's Perriman. The Ravens get a new set of downs. Give them 17 on that pickup.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
No gain on that run, and while this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about different style of running in order to get this guy going.
Let's go! Three, let's go! Go on! Back to the
end. Now Beathard. Throw right side to Perriman, and it's caught. The Raven passing game getting in sync, another first down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now, the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Right side caught, Fedorowicz. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Green 39!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback and makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to go backward. They get him behind the line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, but the net gain, 3 points.
And you're going to have drives like that in this league. Sometimes you just got to take the 3 and move on. Always better than nothing.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And out now, here come the Bengals. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that. Super tough.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It's a 6 yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
On 2nd down, here's Wilson. Quick hitter here, it's complete. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 1:59 to go in the first half. We're back to Baltimore after this. Now Wilson on 2nd down. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
2nd down, 9 yards to go. From the shotgun, Wilson firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a 3rd down. Wilson now to throw on 3rd down. Complete to the right side. It's Eifert. A 3 yard gain and enough for the 1st down. And there on 3rd and short, they just tried to spread the field. It worked.
And I think that the spreading of the field, the extra receivers, has really become the next in the evolutionary chain in the NFL. Go all the way back in that situation, you're handed to the fullback, right? As we evolved, maybe you pitched it to your tailback. Now you spread the field, and you have your choices of where to throw it and complete it for a 1st down.
10 yards there on a Bengal first.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
On 1st and 10, it's Wilson being chased out left. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. Eifert, the man in motion. A Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. Flushed out right. That is caught at the 7. And he'll be out of bounds all the way down at the 5-yard line. A really good pickup of 28 yards. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. Now Wilson. This will be caught at about the 5. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number 1. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They come out with 1 back and 3 tight ends. Now it's Wilson. The quick slant caught. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Now a timeout. 7 seconds left in the first half. The offense on third down, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and goal. Again, Wilson. Flush to his right. He made, and he will score. Touchdown, Cincinnati. Russell Wilson in the final seconds of the first half. And the Bengals add on to their lead.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. An update from a game going on in Indianapolis. It's the Colts in that one that have grabbed the early lead. That one tight to this point, and you'd have to imagine it'll stay tight throughout. The second half upon us sooner than we bargained for. Let's get to it. These teams are out and ready to go. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This is taken at his 4. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
Looking for Strong, and it's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And they will finally get to him, but a great return has set him up. First and goal at the 5. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now,
and he's got his big tight end, Eifert, and it's a Bengal touchdown. Tyler Eifert, his first touchdown on the year. And the Bengals use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And now here come the Ravens. And last time wasn't pretty. 1 play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. He's going to loft one deep left, and that's caught inside the 30. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Rashad Perriman, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Ravens cut into that lead. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Bengal offense now gets set to head back out onto the field. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
So the D-line's going to spread out. There's Wilson to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 18 yards on that one, and the Bengals are moving. First down. So the offense has it, first and 10. From the gun, it's Wilson. And his throw here is incomplete.
Let's phrase this delicately, okay? Might have had a better option instead of throwing the football into double coverage.
He was blanketed. I was surprised that he went his direction.
Yeah, should have thought maybe about the check down. Take the completion, keep moving.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this for about four up to the 46-yard line.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
On third down, Wilson. They set up the screen to Hill. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down of the 46. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
Escaping the pressure right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
Throwing is Wilson, and this one's incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Here's Wilson, and he comes back with one complete. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down. The Bengals' passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first. Now a first down carry. It's Hill. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. To throw is Wilson. Looking to throw on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it was real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Now Wilson. Dancing to his left. He can run for it, and he will. The rushing numbers for Wilson, maybe down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down.
These type of plays are backbreakers for a defense. They thought they had him hemmed in, thought they were going to get him on the ground with the pass rush, but were unable to do so. He gets away, picks up a big first down, and sets up first and goal inside the 10.
That is caught at the 7-yard line. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. A gain of 9 there. Sets up second and goal.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Second and goal from the 1. Now a handoff here to his running back. And I think they stopped him again. They did at the 1-yard line. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on 3rd and goal. This offense on 3rd down today, they've been excellent. 6 for 7. They're looking at a 3rd and goal here. And he motions the wide receiver. Defense likely bringing pressure here. 3rd and goal from the 2. And not going to be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage.
Now this feels like old school football because this has turned into a good old fashioned goal line stand. So on offense, what do you do now? Do you decide to run it or throw it if you go for it on 4th down?
Oh, and now movement and a whistle, and they may have to rethink their plans on 4th down. He loses 5 full yards to bring up 4th. And his kick is good. And that'll push the lead up to 17. So a 15-play drive. Can't believe that only resulted in 3, but it did.
That is somewhat amazing, isn't it? When you hold the ball that long, run offense that well, yet only put 3 points on the board, it has to be a little bit of a disappointment, doesn't it?
Has to. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2-minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Back to throw, Beathard. Fighting his way through contact. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. But with his size coming out of the backfield, usually takes more than an arm tackle to get him down. That's why they like to get him involved in the passing game.
No doubt about it. You saw him running that angle route there and catching the ball. And with his size, not often thought to have hands, but we're hearing that more and more. Guys are doing a better job of catching the ball at any size coming out of the backfield because they need to be a full part of the offense.
They'll throw here, Beathard. And the hookup here with Jalen Strong complete. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. The Raven passing game getting in sync, another 1st down.
All right, here we go.
To throw is Beathard. Looking deep downfield. And that one incomplete. They try to sneak in a deep ball with the clock running down. So incomplete on 1st. Let's see what 2nd down has in store. Here's Beathard to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30. The Raven passing game getting in sync. Another 1st down. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. And to give this time to the tailback. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
While there was no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster.
And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Darren Waller, his 1st touchdown on the year. And the Ravens get a bit closer. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Brandon, is all about pace and tempo now for them. They've got the advantage, so I'm going to put musical terms for you. You don't want to go prestissimo. That's too quick, too lively, right? But you also don't want to slow it down too much. You don't want to go lento. What you really want to be is moderato. Nice and even, nice and steady, get those gains, and close out the game.
I think that chicken parm from last night's gone to your head.
Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And all the way down to the 12. A big play there on the catch and run. And even 60 yards.
Well, probably the only thing he did wrong there was go out of bounds, nursing this fourth quarter lead. You want to stay in, eat the clock.
Yeah, you got to love the effort to catch the extra yardage, but you got to know the situation. Stay in bounds, young man.
And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up 2nd down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. 2nd and 10. It's Wilson again. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Call it a pickup of 7. And just like that, it's 3rd down. Now a handoff as they run left side. And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. A great effort there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Bengals are able to grow their lead. And it's up and good. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here comes the Raven offense now, ready for another possession. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Beathard. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down. Those short little routes probably going to be open. The defense, they'll let those happen, especially when they can make an inbounds tackle.
Yeah, where's Coach Madden when you need him? He always talked about taking what the defense gives you, but sometimes you have to know when you have to take more. That was one of those situations.
They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. Here we go now. To throw is Beathard. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be 2nd down.
All right, here we go. 3, 19.
Here's Beathard to throw. Eluding the pressure right. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's 3rd down.
Yeah, not much there that time, and I think we were both wondering once he got out of the box whether he just throw the ball away, and he winds up only picking up 1 yard or 2.
The Ravens on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13. He'll look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down, but a nice little gain. And before this 4th and 3 play, we're going to get whistles and a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down.
Leppard! Leppard! Hurry up! Here we go!
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. He's got the completion to Strong. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Give him six on the play. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. Now a play fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Yannick Ngakoue in there to bring him down for a loss of seven. And the eighth play on this drive coming up.
All right, here we go. Green, 39.
Perriman in motion right. A play fake as they set up to throw. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets it down to the 32. They do get 10 back, but still a ways to go on fourth.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Ravens cut into that lead. Checking the NFL scoreboard, they're in the fourth now in Minneapolis. And the gap in that one has widened. The Bears have scored again. A win, if they can get it, would be their first on the year. Well, the Ravens say they have it. They do have it. Well, that certainly makes things more interesting. You get the score, then you get the onside kick. A little uphill battle still, but a start.
It's not mission accomplished, but the plan is working. They are in a great spot right now, and the best part, they put the defense right back out on the field after having already scored.
Yeah, they've got the momentum here now. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Give him a couple on the catch at second and eight. And right now, defensively, you love that, don't you? I mean, you'll give them that play.
And they'll take it every single time. This is almost like nickeling and diming it downfield, and too much time's going to run off the clock.
And he stopped immediately there. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight. Big boys down there in the trenches and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you're talking about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead as the clock will stop with 45 seconds left to go in the game. And Charles, in this situation, this is where the word miracle comes into play.
Have to score real fast, maybe throw a jump ball in the end zone and hope for the best.
Now Beathard. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off at the 18. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had two interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are and positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a second and 11. A lot of scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because both teams finding ways to click. And you know people who love this game.